This is Kenneth R. Johnson bringing to you a presentation on sewage sludge treatment in the north. What is sludge? Sewage sludge, also known as biosolids, is what is left behind after water is cleaned in waste treatment works. It's high in organic content and plant nutrients, and in theory makes good fertilizer. However, most developed countries regulate its use because it can contain a multitude of metals, organic pollutants, and pathogens. So you can see sort of the before, you've got sewage coming in, and then after you've got the clear effluent and the sewage sludge. Now a difference for Dawson that may not be the same as communities in the south is that there's not a lot of industry. So you don't see what you'd normally see in the south as metals or organic pollutants. So really we've got the sewage sludge, I suppose you could call it, is clean. It's biodegradable material and nutrients. So it is a good sludge, if there is such a thing, and has the opportunities for use as a fertilizer if it's properly treated. So this is the problem with sludge in a northern context. This is the sludge management system in the community of Pangnirtun, Nunavut. So Pangnirtun is north of Iqaluit, so it's in the high Arctic. But in Pangnirtun, they produce about 500 liters of sludge per day, or 16 cubic meters per month. And it is bagged, as you see in the upper right-hand corner, and taken to the landfill. But what happens in the landfill, because of the bagging and the cold climate, is that it just accumulates, and it is causing quite a problem in Pangnirtun, because you're getting a small amount of sludge that is building up in the Pang landfill. And in most cases, and Pangnirtun is probably more of an exception, is that the landfill has limited capacity. You've got the sewage sludge building up, whereas there is an opportunity to actually use it and treat it and use it as a fertilizer. So there are a number of technologies for treating sludge. The process overall is called sludge stabilization, and it's extremely important in any sludge management program, providing a number of benefits. So you reduce the number of pathogens as the first benefit, you reduce the odor potential as the second benefit, and you provide a uniform product that, again, you can reuse, say, as a fertilizer as the third benefit from treating sludge. The technologies that are available, first I'll describe aerobic digestion and anaerobic. So aerobic digestion is a biological treatment process, possibly not unlike necessarily the actual treatment of sewage itself, but you allow the bacteria and the sludge to consume the organics. This process uses an engineered lagoon or a tank with aeration to provide the oxygen for this process. The second process for treating sludge is anaerobic stabilization. So it's still a biological process where bacteria in the sludge are consumed without any oxygen. This process uses an engineered tank that is sealed, so it occurs in the without the presence of oxygen. And as a result of that, it is much more difficult to control, and actually in some cases if the tank is not well sealed, produces a very significant odor. So it's somewhat more complicated than the aerobic digestion stabilization. Some other types of stabilization, you've got chemical stabilization, where you can add alkaline, or you can make alkaline activity by adding quicklime or hydrated lime to chemically stop the continuing biological activity. This process also uses an engineered tank. There's also composting stabilization, where you use bacteria and the dewatered sludge to consume the organics in an aerobic environment. This process can use actually a pile or an engineered container. And the last one is physical stabilization, and you can use freeze thaw. So physical stabilization uses heat or cold to create dewatered sludge that stops any biological activity. Again, you use an engineered container. But the two processes of potential use for Dawson are this composting stabilization and the physical stabilization or freeze-thaw. Those things are actually of potential interest for Dawson and have been applied and are being used in Iqaluit, Nunavut. So Iqaluit sludge management program or program study, so they've got a phase one of their sewage treatment plant that was completed in 2006, which has the fine screening and grit coming off and going to the landfill, and then the primary filter that comes off. And they're looking about 80 liters per day of fine screening and grit, and 1,720 liters per day, or 1.7 cubic meters, coming off for the primary. They have a second phase of the construction coming up in the future, where they will have the secondary treatment that will produce upward of 3.5 cubic meters a day that will require stabilization and disposal. So in looking at the Iqaluit project, you can actually take advantage of the northern climate when dealing with sludge management. You've got extreme cold. Iqaluit had a minus 46 in 1967. You've got some warmth for limited periods, but it can get upward of 30 degrees C, or in Iqaluit, I think a record was set at plus 26. And then you've got limited rainfall, so near desert conditions in a lot of the far north, where you can get less than 250 millimeters per year of precipitation. And these things actually work well together for some of these physical and composting related processes. Other practices in the north, in Fort Smith, they have a lagoon system, and they periodically remove the sludge from their primary lagoon and put it into a drying bed, which produces a product used on the local golf course. It's essentially drying and composting. So for a technology selection, this was applied to Iqaluit and certainly could be applied to Dawson, as you've got the freeze-thawing, the separation of particles and water, facilitating the dewatering. You've got the drying, which increases the dry matter content of the sludge, and then ultimately you've got the composting, which is the stabilization and destruction of possible pathogens. In applying this process, there is a significant timeline for it to occur. So this can occur as something like a sort of an 18 to 24 month period, where you've got the freezing period from October possibly through till the end of May. Then you've got a composting period from June, July, August, and September. And finally, sort of a maturity phase where you're letting it to rest and stabilize further. And then sort of at the end of it, in this process with the year one, year two, and year three, you've got the utilization. So you can produce a usable end product rather than a product that just goes to the landfill and is just buried. There are differences in the uses of the sludge depending on what the pathogens are that remaining in the material. If you've got some pathogens that could remain, then you would probably have to use it at the landfill. But then again, soil material is very expensive, so if you could use some other materials, such as a composted material, to use as a landfill cover, that would be much better than using other materials that come from the community. And of course, in Iqaluit case, granular material, other material is worth upward of $40 to $50 a cubic meter. So this composted soil that comes out of their process is actually a very valuable material. This is the process operation in Iqaluit. You've got raw sludge on the left-hand side of the photo. You've got the mixing area on the right, where the raw sludge is mixed with wood waste as a bulking agent. And then you've got the composting piles, and these piles are set up where they're actually periodically mixed with a special bucket that goes onto the front end loader. And ultimately, again, over an 18 to 24 month period, you end up with a sort of a soil-like material that the city of Iqaluit will be using for landfill cover. That's the end of this presentation.